So this is a very, very, very nice sample of very fine copper wire. So the copper wire here is, what width is this? This is 0.0, I'm not gonna, that's just too small.
Copper is unusual among the metals in that it's colored. It's really only copper and gold that are colored. So you can see here, we have copper coins. In fact, you can see this one looks brighter than that one. That's a modern one that's been plated. And you can see it's a slight cheat because modern UK coins, although they have copper inside, have iron inside. So with a magnet, you can just pick them up. But the proper copper coins are not magnetic at all.
So it's 0.1 of a millimeter. So the copper wire here is very, very high grade. This is grade one copper wire, and it's 0.1 of a millimeter in diameter, and you can see the wonderful copperous luster.
Copper compounds are not very reactive. In fact, if you put iron filings into copper sulfate or some other copper salt, the copper coats out on the iron filings, which are grey, and then they go a nice sort of rosy colour, almost like gold. It's often one of the first experiments that people do as chemists.
What do you mean by grade one copper?
So this is very, very high purity. This is like 99.99% copper, used for electronics fabrications and high quality research samples. It's a very beautiful sample.
On the other hand, and quite surprisingly, that copper chloride is quite reactive. I did an experiment once in which I took a cupcake container, which is made of aluminium, and put copper chloride in it, solution, and it boiled. I was trying to demonstrate how reactive it was to my children. I didn't notice that the copper chloride had burnt through the aluminium and made a hole in our sitting room carpet. Most organisms, you and me, use iron in our blood to transport oxygen. That's what makes our blood red. But in some sorts of crustacean, crabs and lobsters, they're different. They use copper. They use a compound called hemocyanin. It's a blue compound of copper. Cyan is some classical word for blue. So they really have blue blood. And these hemocyanin uses two atoms of copper in each molecule to transport the oxygen around the body of the crab or lobster. But it's not nearly as good as hemoglobin. So if you start running after a crab or lobster, it quickly gets tired compared to running after a rabbit or something like that, which can keep going faster than you can.